Yeah.
So do you think we lack technocrats in our bureaucracy? Because
do we lack what in the bureaucracy?
Technocrats.
Technocrats.
Because when it comes to data science, India lacks something.
No, by and large that is true, in that our bureaucratic selection process very much emphasizes the generalist. So essentially, you are supposed to be able to work in the civil supplies ministry today, the defense ministry tomorrow, the be a district collector the day after. This kind of polyvalence that every Indian bureaucrat in the central services is supposed to have, and is mirrored also in the state services. So the result is that there is an assumption that everybody should be able to do everything. And that is partly a legacy of the old British approach to governance, partly also a perception that the respect for technocracy is relatively new in global administrative practice. But increasingly the need for expertise is being felt. As chairman of the External Affairs Committee of Parliament, I have pushed very strongly, and my committee has authored a report as well, that has said that we should take technocrats on a mid-career contract basis as lateral entrants into the service. There's a lot of resistance from the civil service because they don't want people who have not gone through the examinations and the training they have gone through to be able to come in that way. But the truth is, if you look objectively at a number of areas today, say climate change negotiations, that's a very specialized field. You can't just have any old diplomat whose last job was attending a cocktail party in Moscow to come and negotiate on climate change. But that, unfortunately, is the way the government has been doing it. So we need to actually take on board people who are experts. Or you take an issue, shall we say, like outer space policy, negotiations on rocket and satellite technology. It's all very well, you may have done your IIT degree before taking the UPSC examinations, but that doesn't qualify you 20 years later to negotiate on 21st century issues of outer space, or cyber security, whatever. So the need to have some expertise is there. I don't know that you are going to succeed in getting technocrats full-time into the service for careers, because their expertise as technocrats will itself become out of date. So you take a young expert in whatever field, let's say you take a space technologist in his 20s into the IAS, by the time he's in the 30s, he's out of date, unless he's really spent his, willing to spend his entire career being only a space technologist and focusing only on that. But then we don't have those streams in our government either. So the compromise solution that I offered was to take people on five-year contracts. Then, if they are happy and they want to continue and they're contributing well and you want to keep them, even if that means they're sacrificing the possibility of a normal career in terms of very high promotions and so on, if they want to stay on, they can. Otherwise, let them go back to their field, let them go to be back to being a professor or an official at ISRO or whatever else they're doing. You take a new fresh blood with the current state-of-the-art cutting-edge thinking on space technology. That kind of thing is possible. But the government is not flexible enough at the moment. In response to a question I raised in Parliament, the Minister in the Prime Minister's office, Jitendra Singh, told me he would set up a committee to look at the modalities of lateral entry, and he told me I would be on that committee. I said, very good. 2 years later, that committee has still not started, and now the government is coming to the end of its tenure. So I think that a serious study needs to be done on lateral entry in the civil